about something, some basic facts about diabetes. The first question that comes to anybody's mind is, like, what actually diabetes is? So diabetes is a state where there is absolute or relative insulin deficiency, because of which the glucose does not get into the cells but keeps circulating in the blood, because of which they are found in very high levels in the blood. So this is called diabetes. The second question which pops up in our mind is, are all diabetes the same? So the answer is that 95% of the diabetes which we see are type 2 diabetes mellitus. Means it is a state of relative insulin deficiency. So what does it mean? Type 2 diabetes is commonly seen in obese persons in whom the insulin production is there, but it is not in the level to maintain the blood sugars in a normal range. Means they have insulin resistance. So this is type 2 diabetes, which is 95% of the diabetes which we treat as an outpatient basis. So it is commonly seen in obese. So previously it was believed that it is even more common above 40 years of age. But with the urbanization and the stressful life that we are having, now it can be seen at any age, even in adolescents. Now type 2 diabetes mellitus is being diagnosed with increased frequency. Another type of diabetes, which is type 1 diabetes mellitus, which is an absolute deficiency of insulin in the body. So type 1 diabetes mellitus previously was called as juvenile type of diabetes or insulin dependent diabetes, but now it is called type 1 diabetes mellitus. The type 1 diabetes mellitus is different from type 2. The reason being that in this type of diabetes, number one, medications don't work. Reason being, oral medications don't work. The reason being that there is an absolute insulin deficiency in the body, which means that the body is not producing sufficient insulin to metabolize the sugars. This is more common in children, but this does not mean that adults do not have this type of diabetes. Even in adults, we can have type 1 diabetes. It is different from type 2 in the presentation also, because suddenly the patient loses excessive weight and he has severe polyuria, severe thirst, and we see that in the urine the ketones are positive. And if this is not addressed, it becomes severe enough to cause diabetic ketoacidosis, which is an emergency, and it is one of the key features which is present at the presentation of type 1 diabetes mellitus. Oral glucose tolerance test. Now, what does it mean? Oral glucose glucose tolerance test means that we give the patient 75 grams of anhydrous glucose, which has to be taken in water over a period of 3 to 5 minutes. So the fasting sample is drawn before this glucose is being given, and 2 hours after the glucose intake, the post-glucose sugars are measured. So if the fasting sugar is equal to or more than 126, that is classified as diabetes. Post glucose, 2 hours after drinking of glucose, if the blood sugar is equal to or more than 200, it is labeled as diabetes. So this is the gold standard. Other tests are HbA1c, means glycosylated hemoglobin. This measures the average blood glucose of the last 3 to 4 months. So in 2010, ADA has allowed the HbA1c to be used as a marker of diagnosis of diabetes in patients. If a HbA1c report is equal to or more than 6.5, it is classified as diabetes mellitus requiring medication. Generally, the mindset of every person is, I don't have a family history of diabetes mellitus. So, did I have diabetes mellitus or not? So, answer is that type 2 diabetes mellitus is related to epigenetic phenomenon, which means that it is influenced by genes which can cause diabetes mellitus. At the same time, it also depends upon the environmental factors in which you are surviving. So let us see, if a patient has got a family history of diabetes, it means that genetically he is prone compared to other patients who does not have a family history of having diabetes mellitus more. But if this patient is maintaining an active lifestyle, is eating a good healthy lifestyle, keeping his weight under check, eating healthy food, exercising daily, so the onset of diabetes will be delayed to very late ages. At the same time, if a person's family history is not there for diabetes mellitus, but he does not eat healthy food, does not maintain a healthy lifestyle, even he can have diabetes at a younger age. So it's an amalgamation of genetic predisposition at the same time of environment in which these genes are surviving. Patient is diabetic and he is classified as type 2 diabetic or type 1 diabetic. The medications are used accordingly. In type 2 diabetes mellitus, oral medications are the first drug of choice if the sugars are not very high. But in type 1 diabetes mellitus, insulin is the drug of choice. In the type 2 diabetes mellitus, many types of oral medications are there, which are broadly we can classify as insulin sensitizers and insulin secretagogues. Means one which increases the insulin production to more than double. So these tablets like glimepiride, they belong to this type of levetiracetam, they all belong to this type of category. And another tablet is the insulin sensitizers, means they don't increase the production of the insulin, but they allow the body to utilize the insulin available with them in a more efficient way. So the metformin group is one of the most commonly used drugs for insulin sensitizers. Advantage of insulin sensitizers are predominantly the hypoglycemia threshold is low, they help in reducing the weight, and they have other benefits. If we talk about insulin secretagogues, which means they each increase the production of insulin, they are very fast acting, but they have the side effect of hypoglycemia if the patient does not eat the food at the right time.